In this video, we'll discuss how to write an equation describing a chemical reaction and how to classify different chemical reactions. For a chemical reaction that involves ionic compounds, the reaction proceeds via a double exchange procedure where the cation of the first substance combines with the anion of the second one, and the anion combines with the cation of the second one. And we can classify reactions depending on what type of process taking place. The first type is called substitution or single displacement reaction, where a metal displaces hydrogen in the acid, making a metal salt and release hydrogen as a pure element. The second type is double displacement reaction. The cation of the first substance combines with the anion of the second one, while the anion combines with the cation of the second one. The third type is oxidation-reduction reaction, or sometimes called redox reactions. And those types of reactions involve electron transfer between the reactants. If you follow the oxidation state, you will find that these reactants will undergo a change in oxidation state. For example, magnesium here starts with an oxidation state of zero because it's a pure element, a neutral element, while hydrogen is plus one. When you react them together, you will make a magnesium salt with magnesium having a two plus charge, which means it lost two electrons, while hydrogen will have a zero charge, which means it gained two electrons. The fourth type is called combination reactions, where you start with a larger number of reactants and you end up with a smaller number of reactants. So reactants combine to make products. And the opposite of that is decomposition reactions, where you start with a smaller number of reactants and you end up with much more number of products. We'll talk about some specific types of reactions, and we'll start with precipitation reactions. A precipitation reaction is any reaction that produces a precipitate or a solid substance out of the reaction medium. A precipitate means an insoluble solid substance that separates from the solution of the reaction. An example for that, when you combine lead nitrate and potassium iodide together, you will have a possible combination between lead and iodide. And this combination have a very low solubility, and that's why it starts separating or depositing out of the solution as a solid substance or a precipitate. So the description for this process in this case is the combination between lead ions and iodide ions to make lead iodide solid. This appears as a yellow precipitate that deposits in the solution like this. Whether a precipitate will form in a combination of solutions or not depends on the solubility of the substance. Solubility means the maximum amount of that salt that can dissolve in a unit volume of the solvent at a certain temperature. There are solubility rules that will allow you to predict whether a certain combination of ions is going to be soluble or insoluble. And in turn, it's going to allow you to predict if a precipitation reaction is going to take place or not. The first rule is that group 1 salts and ammonium salts are always soluble, no matter what anion is combined with them. And also salts of nitrate, chlorate, perchlorate, and acetate are always soluble no matter what cation is combined with them. Second rule is that salts of halides, meaning chloride, bromide, and iodide, are always soluble except if they're combined with these three ions here. They will become insoluble. So third rule is that salts of fluoride are always soluble except if they are combined with this set of cations here, they will become insoluble. Finally, salts of sulfate are always soluble, except if they're combined with this set of cations here, they will become non-soluble. Second set of rules is for insoluble compounds. Carbonates, phosphates, oxalates, chromates, and sulfides are always insoluble, except if they are combined with ammonium or group 1 cations, because we said ammonium and group 1 cations are going to be always soluble no matter what anions are combined with. Also, hydroxides and oxides are always insoluble, except if they are combined with group 1 cations or barium and strontium. In this case, they will become soluble. So you can apply these rules to make prediction about the solubility of any combination of ions. For example, if you look at this combination here, sodium is group 1. As we said, group 1 is always soluble, even if it's combined with phosphate, like this case here. So this is going to be a soluble substance, and we represent soluble substance with the abbreviation AQ, standing for aqueous. Lead chloride, if we go back to the previous rule, chlorides are always soluble except if they are combined with lead. So lead chloride is going to be the exception here, so it's going to be insoluble. And we represent this with an S, standing for a solid that does not dissolve in water. Copper acetate, this form here is the formula for acetate. So copper acetate, if we look at the rule for acetate solubility, acetates are always soluble no matter what cations they're combined with. So copper acetate is going to be always soluble, so it's aqueous. Magnesium hydroxide. So hydroxides are always insoluble unless it's a hydroxide of alkali metals or barium or strontium. Magnesium is not one of them, so that's going to be an insoluble combination. So that's an insoluble substance. So how can we best describe precipitation reactions? As we said, we exchange the cation of the first ion with the anion of the second, and the anion with the cation of the second. So we'll get a combination of AgCl with KNO3. Then we need to specify the solubility. KNO3 is a combination of a group 1 cation with nitrate. This combination is always soluble. Both components are always soluble, so that's going to be a soluble substance. Since it says this is a precipitation reaction, by default that means that the second substance is going to be insoluble. But you can always make this prediction based on what combination of cation versus anion you have. This here is the molecular equation. This second reaction here is going to be the cation of the first substance combined with the anion of the second, and the anion combined with the cation of the second. So we get VPBS plus 2NH4NO3. Second step is going to be describing the physical state of the substance. Is it soluble or insoluble? Again, this is a combination of ammonium with nitrate. This combination is going to be always soluble according to the rules. So that's going to be AQ. And that makes the second substance an insoluble substance. But again, we can make this prediction by looking at the combination of lead with sulfide. According to the rules, sulfides are always insoluble. These, as we said, are the molecular equation describing the reactions. But as we said, these are not accurate descriptions because they don't take into account the fact that soluble substances exist in solution as ions, not as formulas. In order to account for this fact, we have to do the ionic equation that best describes the actual situation in solution. Any substance that is soluble is gonna split into the corresponding ions. So AgNO3 in solution exists as Ag plus ions that are soluble and NO3 minus ions that are soluble. KCl also splits to K plus ions and Cl minus ions. Solid substances doesn't dissolve, so they're not gonna split. So anything that is insoluble is not gonna split. So AgCl is gonna stay the same, while KNO3 is soluble, so it's gonna split to the corresponding ions, K plus ions plus NO3 minus ions. This here is called the total ionic equation. It describes all the ions in existing in solution, but some of these ions undergo a reaction. Some of these ions remain unchanged after the reaction is conducted. If you look at nitrate before and after the reaction, you will see that it remains the same. It didn't change at all. So that's called the spectator ion, that an ion that doesn't change during the course of the reaction. Cross out anything that does not undergo a change, any spectator ion. Nitrate is a spectator ion, doesn't undergo a change. Potassium is a spectator ion, it doesn't undergo a change. So that leaves the ions that actually underwent a change during the course of the reaction, which is Ag plus ions that combines with Cl minus ions to make a solid AgCl precipitate. This here is the net ionic equation that describes the actual reaction that takes place. So let's apply this to the second example. What we see in this second example is the molecular equation. And as we said, that doesn't take into account the fact that any ion that is soluble is gonna split in solution. So that's what we will do, which is split the soluble ions into the solution. It's gonna be Pb2 plus plus two ions of NO3 minus two NH4 plus plus S2 minus. And on the right-hand side, only NH4 NO3 is gonna split. It's gonna be two NH4 plus plus two NO3 minus. While the solid insoluble substance is gonna remain the same, PPS solid is gonna remain the same. Any ion that does not undergo a change is a spectator ion, and we can cross it out. Nitrate is the same before and after the reaction. Ammonium is the same before and after the reaction. That leaves the ions that actually underwent a change during the reaction, which is lead ions that combined with sulfide ions to make lead sulfide precipitate. This here is the net ionic equation that describes the actual reaction that took place.